What is up, guys? How you doing? Just kidding, I don't care. Today I'm going to show you something that's different. I feel like every video is different. A Funko Pop Freddie Mercury. And I'm going to be honest with you, I don't really like Funko Pops. To me, it's because I think they're lazy. Like, I know they make millions of them, but it's literally just the same design, but then different alternate features. And boom, that's a different person. I kind of dislike this and like this in a way. I dislike it because I feel like people waste too much money. They cost like $15, somewhere around that, the simple ones. And you're basically spending $15 on just a small figure when you already paid $15 for just a different version of this figure. I'd rather have like more detailed, you know, figures, not Funko Pops. But in a way, I kind of think it's impressive because I think it's incredible how even though there's not much detail, all you need to do is add very little things and you can already tell who that is. There's no wrinkle effect or anything on the face, no detail, barely. It's just a box head and yet you can still tell that's Freddie Mercury, who, by the way, is my all-time favorite singer and the lead singer of my all-time favorite band. And they just so happen to sing my all-time favorite song. Guess which one that is. Killed a man, but he got against his head. My trigger, now he's dead. So let's talk about the box. It's just a clear plastic window of the figure, which also falls to the side, which I think is a pretty cool design. It's simple, but still looks cool. I'm definitely going to keep this in the box because I think it looks cooler in the box than out of the box. I think it looks a lot cooler. There's like a drawing of the figure and it only shows here. There's Freddie Mercury in the bottom, Queen on top, and it says number 96. Then it says Pop Rocks with the Funko Pop logo. On the top is the Funko Pop logo with the head of the Freddie Mercury figure. On the side, it says Pop Rocks logo again, Freddie Mercury again, 96 number again. The Freddie Mercury drawing and a concert background, which I think looks pretty cool. Then it just says Freddie Mercury on the side, 96, top of head, Pop logo. Yeah, this is kind of repetitive. Then the bottom, it has the Queen logo, which I think looks awesome. The Pop Rocks logo, 96 number. Yes, we get it. You're a Funko Pop. The same drawing and the other Queen figures, which you can buy. I'm not going to buy them. Literally, this is my first Funko Pop figure ever. And the only reason I bought it is because it's Freddie Mercury, and I just desperately wanted a Freddie Mercury figure because this just looks cool. So even though this is my first, this is most likely the only Funko Pop I'll ever have. So anyways, there's also a bunch of logo, legal writing in the bottom and also here. So anyways, let's open this up and let's see the figure itself. As you can see, these figures are pretty small. They only go at about, almost 4 inches. That's not really much. So anyways, as you can see, it's just in its usual Funko Pop style with the big giant box head and the tiny regular body. And I think they did a good job. It does kind of look like Freddie Mercury, but I don't know. I just don't like designs of Funko Pops, like pure black dots, tiny nose, tiny ears. And yeah, that's pretty much it. But I still like this one because even though it has very small detail, just by the mustache and the hair, you can already tell that's Freddie Mercury, which I think is pretty impressive. So anyways, the face is just simple and it has the black dots. It's Freddie eyebrows and his Freddie mustache, which I think looks pretty cool. Even though there's no mouth or anything, they still do a good job making it look like the person. And it's in his usual Freddie haircut style. It kind of looks like the one he had in Live Aid, although I don't like that when I bought it, it had a white scratch here. So this is one of the reasons I'm keeping it in the box. For one thing, I think it looks better in the box, and the other, I don't have to look at that. Ew. So anyways, as you can see, it's in his iconic Freddie Mercury pose. This is honestly one of the best moments in the history of music, so I think it's awesome to have a figure in this pose. I think that's really cool. I do prefer the SH figure as Freddie Mercury, but, you know, I'm not full of money, so this will work. So as you can see, it has his plain white shirt, his iconic white pants with the red stripes, and his really well-known yellow jacket with the 10 belts. Well, 6 belts here.
And as you can see, it's shown pretty well. Each individual hole is shown, sticking out, and there you go. It's 10 belts over here. Six. I don't know what's wrong with me. Six. There is some creasing wrinkled effect on the shirt, which I think looks pretty cool. Then you see some chest hair. He didn't really shave his chest hair much, which I think still made him look badass. So, yeah. You see there's like gold lining over here, and it also around the arm here. There's also a crease and wrinkled effect on the jacket, which I think looks pretty cool. And there's not really much detail on the hand, but I still think it works. You can still see the individual fingers. They're not individual, but it still looks individual. And on his other arm, you see him holding his... I know I keep saying iconic much, but this man is an icon. He's iconic. He's an incredible part of music history. And I've been listening to him my whole life. So you see his microphone stand, which actually, yeah, the Bohemian Rhapsody movie, that part was accurate. He did break a microphone stand, and he liked having it like this because he felt like this was good. Like, it was easier to hold the microphone this way. It was more comfortable. Instead of just holding the simple microphone, he found this more comfortable because he had something to hold. So yeah, then you see his actual white belt with the gold buckle and the gold holes, which I think looks pretty cool. You see there's the small detail in the pants, you know, the button. And there you see his iconic Adidas shoes with the that are pure white with the black stripe. Then it's pure gray at the bottom. And you see some legal writing there. And that's pretty much it. So the detail's pretty good. And again, it's impressive how even though there's very little detail, like very focused, you can still tell who the person is. So anyways, let's talk about articulation. On the head, and that's it. Yep, you can't move this at all. That's just it. But it doesn't really bother me because this is already an awesome and iconic pose. So I still want, I would just keep it this pose anyways. So kind of works. In the end, what do I think of this figure? I think it was worth buying. It did cost me $15, and it works. It does work. I'm keeping it in the box, again, because the box looks pretty cool, and again, I think it looks better in the box than out of the box. Those are very few times where I actually do think that, and yeah, I think it looks cooler in the box. So I think this is worth buying if you don't want the SH figure as Freddie Mercury, because that's the only figure I've seen that has, you know, this clothing. So I think it's worth buying. Thank you for watching. If you want to see more of this, subscribe to my channel and click the notification button. Thank you for watching.